What is going on, guys? 2.0 here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you guys how to get a lot of glimmer. So I never really had an issue getting glimmer in year one of Destiny, but currently in year two of the game I do find myself short on glimmer quite often, and I can only really put that down to the fact that I use a lot more of it now, especially whenever Arms Day rolls around, as I do buy 9 packages from the gunsmith, 3 on each character, and they do cost 2,500 glimmer each. So that just there can take away almost a full stack of 25,000 glimmer. On top of this, I use a lot of it throughout the week to level up gear, as well as for infusion, and I do spend a lot of glimmer purchasing runes from Eris to use in the Court of Oryx. As well as this, something I've been burning a large amount of my glimmer into lately is buying weapon parts from the gunsmith, not because I'm low on them, but so that I can go and turn these weapon parts in with the faction vendors to get some really quick and easy faction reputation with them, as I am currently working towards getting all the exotic class items. So even for those of you who, like myself in year one, never seem to have an issue with getting glimmer, this may be useful if you want to quickly power level your chosen faction. So the first method I have for you that you can get 3,000 glimmer by hardly doing anything at all is by simply going to Varric's in the Reef social space every week. As each reset, that's Tuesdays, he will have a package for you, which will always contain 1,000 glimmer, meaning if you have 3 characters, you will be able to get 3 packages every single week for the easiest 3,000 glimmer you could possibly earn. You do need to be at least level 2 on your House of Judgment rank, but that doesn't take too long to achieve at all. Next is a method that anyone can use to farm as much glimmer as you want, and like I say, anyone can do this by simply loading into any of the patrol areas and completing the patrol missions available from the beacons. Now, certain patrol areas are higher level than others. For example, Patrol the Cosmodrome is level 4, whereas Patrol the Dreadnought is level 35. However, you will not gain any additional glimmer by completing the patrol missions on a higher difficulty. So I would recommend just doing the level 4 patrol Cosmodrome, as these will be so much easier to complete, which will result in you doing more of them much faster, and therefore you will be earning your glimmer much more efficiently. So once you have loaded into a patrol area, in my case I chose the Cosmodrome, check to see which missions are available for you to do by simply pulling out your ghost, as certain ones will reward you with more glimmer. The highest paying patrol missions are the kill special target ones, which are represented in game by the symbol on screen now. These will always give you 500 glimmer for each one you do, and all you have to do is go to the set location and take out the marked target. Since the Taken King, the target will always be a major enemy, meaning they will have a yellow health bar, which makes it really easy to quickly identify the correct enemy. So simply find the target and take it out for a very quick and easy 500 glimmer. Next are the Scout and Scan patrol missions. Both are very similar and very easy to complete. The Scout missions, identified by the symbol on screen now, simply require you to go to the set location and stand in that area. It will typically be in an elevated position, think of it as though you are scouting the area out around you, and you may have a few enemies near you that you will need to take out, but apart from that, that is all you need to do and you will have these ones complete. The scan missions are slightly different but do follow that same idea. Scan patrol missions are represented by the symbol here and require you to again go to a set location, but this time you will be scanning something with your ghost. Both scan and scout patrol missions will give you 300 glimmer, which is why these are the next best ones to do. After this, we have the kill and collect patrol missions. These are again very similar to each other, so first we'll take a look at the kill patrols represented by this symbol. These require you to literally just kill enemies, and eventually, once you've killed enough of them, you will be done with this. And then we have the collect missions. The only difference here is that you need to collect items that the enemies you take out drop. For me, I needed to kill fallen dregs and vandals, and you can then pick up the items that they drop afterwards. And again, once you have picked up enough, you're done. And both of these do reward you with 250 glimmer, so they are the least favored ones. It is also worth noting that there are 2 other types of patrol missions available currently, and those are the Taken Enemies as well as the Time Races. Both of these do reward you with 500 glimmer, but the time they take to complete is quite a lot more than the others, so I would avoid these if you want to get as much glimmer as quickly as you can. Also, whilst you're running around doing these patrol missions, you can use the consumables that match the enemies you will encounter. For example, I was patrolling the Cosmodrome, therefore I use Ever Seeds as these generate Glimmer when killing fallen enemies. So this will get you some more Glimmer. It's not a great amount, but if you're going to be running around taking the enemies out anyway, you may as well use some of these if you've got a lot of them stocked up. Another way you can get some more Glimmer is by leveling up the vendors in the tower, as every time you level these vendors' ranks up past rank 3, they will reward you with a package. This package will always reward you with 500 Glimmer, as well as some more useful items. So every time you level up any of your faction ranks, Crucible, Vanguard, Gunsmith, even the Cryptarch, you will get another 500 Glimmer from the package that they reward you with. There are also a lot of consumables that you can pick up whilst doing different activities on Destiny that can be traded in for Glimmer. These consist of House Banners from Fallen Enemies, Silken Codex from Hive, Axiomatic Beads from Vex, and finally Network Keys from the Cabal. These can be traded in with the Cryptarch for 200 Glimmer each, and so what I've done is stored any of these that I get in my vault, and whenever I'm running really low on Glimmer and I need to buy something, I can just go and take some of these consumables and turn them in. And you can see here, I've saved a lot of them up now. And just like that, in seconds, I've gone from hardly any Glimmer at all to almost a full stack. So saving these consumables up really does help. And whenever you're running really low, you have a nice amount waiting for you over at the tower. So I hope this helps you guys out and gives you a few more ways in which you can earn a lot more Glimmer on Destiny if you find yourselves often running low. And even if you don't, it is a great way to level up your factions, like I said at the start of this video. So let me know down below in the comments what you thought and if you have any other great ways to get more Glimmer that I hadn't mentioned in this video. But that is going to bring us to the end of the video, guys. So if you did enjoy it or learned something new, please leave a like, as it really does help me out. Subscribe if you're new around here, as I upload daily Destiny videos. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys on the next one.